All right, we're back as the Lord. Lord Ethan.
As I was saying, you are young. And there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership. But 300 generations of Forrester lords stand behind you. Lord Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house, and your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good.
And I want to be Lord Ethan.
He was fair and wise and courageous in battle.
Let's see what they're going to call him.
What will they call me?
That is for you to define as the new Lord.
Okay.
These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forrester Lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others, the Lord Sentinel. Forrester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
Okay, I choose you, Pikachu. Who are my choices?
Keep walking, you craven son of a whore. Move. Summon the Lord.
I don't know if I choose him. That guy's a little too vicious.
I've done nothing wrong. I was only trying to survive.
Lord Ethan. Maester.
Why did you kick this man?
This craven is a deserter and a thief.
This house is doomed!
This house is doomed?
We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Okay.
Two shields and three spears.
Is what Sir Roiland said true?
Yes, my lord.
Okay.
I fled. We should all flee. It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right.
He speaks true.
I've a family to feed, and not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here. Where's our pay? Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone.
Mercy. Go.
Lord Ethan. I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter.
No.
Most of us won't even live to see it.
Then you admit to the crime, in front of all gathered here.
I am only what this house made me. You cannot expect a man to live on loyalty alone.
You'll address him as Lord. Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it
the
is.
Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please.
I agree
Their
with
Lord
the uncle.
Will not permit it.
He's a thief.
We can send him to the war.
Leave the man alone. Show him mercy, Malor. He stole from us. Make him pay. Give us justice.
All right.
I will decide.
Send him to the wall.
We're gonna send him to the wall, and then he's gonna join the other plot line.
If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. It will be an injustice, my lord.
You're not you just
Please,
admitted.
My lord, my family depends on me.
I sentence you to the wall, where you will join the Night's Watch.
No, please, my lord! My family, without me, they'll die!
Well. Gotta show some tough love here. Of course my house remember.
That was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must mete out punishment when it's due. Not just yourself, of course.
Maester, what do you think?
Me?
Yes. Did I do what's right?
The wall seems like a fitting place for a thief. I only hope he doesn't find Garrett there and take his anger out on the poor squire.
See, that's what I thought.
You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again. But a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side.
I like the uncle. Can we make the Castellan?
Someone you can rely on, no matter the circumstance. Possessing wisdom and experience.
And I'm sure you think you'd be the perfect choice.
Me?
Oh, gods, no. I can't get involved. I am a maester. At the Citadel, I swore an oath to serve as such. There are two capable men for the role. They both want
the job. You gotta choose the
uncle. But neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here. The bracer of the Sentinel. The badge of office. Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen Sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house.
Sounds good.
Your Sentinel will wear this for all to see.
I'll make the right choice as Sentinel.
Come speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.
Okay. Where are you going to be? You didn't tell me where you're going to be? I'll find you. It's a pretty cool bracer.
It's like, I want that bracer.
I want it too.
Okay, so, of course, when we have important decisions to make, we're going to look at everything except for the important decision to make. Let's go look at the food.
Our provisions are rather low, my lord. I made the count again, just to be sure.
How bad is it? How long could we hold the house?
We couldn't withstand a siege, my lord. If the Boltons or the White Hills cut us off and wait us out, we'd only last a fortnight. But there are steps we can take. In the past, we've demanded food from the small folk to replenish our stores. We can do it again, if you'd like. We've done it before in desperate times. The last long winter, my family had to give all our pigs to the house.
If that's what's necessary to keep the house safe, then we must.
Aye, a hard choice. But it's what has to be done. I'll see to the arrangements, my lord.
I want to be wishy-washy with this kid. Look at Duncan. Look at Duncan. Let's look at Duncan. He's very handsome. What if I walk into this carcass here? Ah, get it off me! Get it off me! Let me talk to him again. Is there anything else to say?
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
I have much to consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
As Lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask, who do you favor for the role? Perhaps I can share my insight. And talking can sometimes help you make a decision.
What do you think of Sir Roiland? Do you trust him?
He's a fine warrior, my lord, but he's nowhere near ready to serve as Sentinel. I do not trust him. He's likely to lose his temper and get us all killed, and at the worst possible time.
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
I'm at your service, my lord.
We'll ask the other guy what he thinks of Duncan. Let's look at Malcolm. Look at Sir Roiland. Who's Malcolm? Let's take a look at him. The look at option is kind of creepy. Let's talk to Malcolm.
Ethan. Or should I say Lord Ethan?
You should say Lord. Oh, he's
I saw what you did today. It's not an easy thing to do. Showing mercy to a man who admits his guilt. But if you'll excuse me, my lord, I should finish packing before nightfall.
Where are you going?
I hope to be off tomorrow. At first light.
But where are you going?
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Asher.
Asher?
She has asked me to return with him. To help the house.
She said nothing of this to me.
Because she fears you will not agree. I told her my place is here, but I'll be of no help to you in Essos. But she insisted. I will hold, of course, until you've spoken with her about this. Just try to be kind to her. She's been living a nightmare made real. But you know that just as well.
She's my mother. Of course I'll be gentle.
I know you will. You're good-hearted, my lord. That is your true strength.
But my mother's fears are not the only ones I face. My people are scared as well. I'm told I must choose a sentinel.
If I may be so bold, Sir Roiland is the man for the job.
Really?
He'd be a fine choice. And I'd trust him. Aye, Sir Roiland is the man you want.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not with the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
It's kind of, you know,
Ethan,
it's kind of
I
right
need
there.
To talk to you.
It's true. Negotiating with Ramsay is not a good idea.
Mother told me Mira has asked for Lady Marjorie's help.
Did she?
I knew we could rely on Mira. She always thinks of family above all else. Hopefully Lady Marjorie's influence will be enough. But right now I'm more concerned about you. I saw what you did to that man. I know you told me you'd have to change, but I suppose I hadn't believed you would.
I can't afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened with Lord Whitehill. Garrod being sent to the wall without my knowledge.
I know. And that wasn't your fault.
Well, I'm the Lord. It's my responsibility.
Yeah, I'm not really feeling for
leave.
The sister.
They need me to, but...
What? Well,
she doesn't get it.
Ethan, please. Tell me.
Who should I name as my sentinel?
It should definitely be Duncan Tuttle. He's dependable and smart, and everyone trusts his judgment. Sir Roiland is unpredictable and likely to make matters worse.
You've always given me good advice. Thank you.
It's a tough choice. I do agree with the... I want to play more of a... You know, I want to be like the Starks. I want to be noble and good and, you know, fair. But Malcolm was totally right. Ramsay Snow... This is no good. I don't want to look at it. Let's just talk.
Drawn up. Swing left. Parry. Wrong. I didn't know
Sir
dogs could hold swords.
The word?
Of course.
Hello. Hello.
I have many decisions to make, and I wanted your advice. I need to name a sentinel.
Ah, you do. And it's good you came to me. I know this house, and everyone here knows me. They know I can hold the reins or wield the sword in
equal
measure.
But your face is all messed up.
And might I remind you, it was Duncan Tuttle who sent Garrod to the wall. He undermined your authority and made you look weak to the White Hills. I would never do that to you. And if you pardon me saying so, I think your father would be proud, seeing you make good choices as a young lord.
I haven't made my decision yet, but I appreciate your opinion.
So, when will you declare your decision, my lord?
Tonight.
Tonight, at the small council meeting.
Very good. I trust your judgment, my lord.
Good, because it's not going to be you! Ha ha! I don't like him. He might be the smart answer, but I don't like him. I want to try to be a good kid with this guy. All right, where
do
are we going?
It like you mean it.
I'm gonna bring this house down single-handedly. Grazer. I'm gonna try to be like the Starks, and that didn't work so well for any of them. So,
Maester.
Yes, Lord Ethan. I see you've spoken to a number of people. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
Let's see what his,
What is it you're doing over here?
Admiring the ironwood, my lord. I studied it at the Citadel. The wood may be black, but I see gold. An entire forest of gold.
What do you mean?
It is our greatest asset, my lord. Why not give some of our ironwood to House Bolton and have them leave us be? We could ransom ourselves. You can hardly put a price on your own life, or the lives of those you love.
How much do we have to give, Maester?
From here to Wolfswood Creek and then across the next two ridges, it should be enough to satisfy Ramsay Snow, I imagine. Bloodlust can often be sated by gifts and gold.
It's not a bad idea.
My lord, are you now ready to name your sentinel?
I am.
Yes, maester. I'm ready.
Very well. I will convene the
Here
small
comes
council.
A terrible choice. I have a feeling a lot of people would choose, though, the warrior guy. This is Game of Thrones, after all. But I'm going to go with Duncan. I'm going to go with my heart here. My gut. Yeah. Let's do this.
You may sit.
I believe Lord Ethan has reached his decision.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you. Duncan, Roiland, this house needs you both.
But you can only choose one, my lord.
Let him be on with it.
Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel, but I have made my decision.
He's gonna get so angry. I choose you!
Duncan Tuttle, you will be my sentinel.
Yay!
Tuttle! This is reckless!
Lord Ethan has made his choice. I will not disappoint you, my lord.
Now, sentinel, what do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
Our scouts say he's only a day's ride from here. With no time to waste.
Who knows what he's capable of? We need to prepare for the worst.
We can devise a plan to deal with him.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword.
That's bloody suicide. You gamble with the lives of everyone within these walls. Ignore Sir Roiland. You named me Sentinel. I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
This is the bloody small council.
Enough! Would my father have stood for this kind of bickering? Neither will I.
Sir Roiland is clearly able and ready to take up arms, but the rest of our soldiers are not. We need to take a cunning approach. Diplomacy can be a sharper instrument than a sword.
The Bolton sigil is a flayed man. Force is the only thing they understand.
Gentlemen, please.
He's totally right.
Thank the gods Mira has asked Lady Marjorie for her help. It's not too late for the Crown to intervene on our behalf.
That's right.
But we must have a plan if Mira's efforts are not successful.
I like the ironwood tree thing.
I trust Mira's judgment. I don't doubt she did everything within her power to help us.
Mother, what do you recommend we do?
We must give him whatever he wants and be done with it. It's too dangerous to do otherwise.
Why not make an offering for peace, my lord?
Yeah, the wisdom of the Citadel.
We can give the Boltons ironwood in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency we have to bargain with.
Enough!
It is diplomacy, we will bargain, we will fight. Oh my god. Huh. Oh, this is a hard one. I like how the camera changes to everybody. Alright, so I don't understand. Like, I want to say diplomacy, but what was the plan on that? Just give him anything? You know, the mother said, give him anything he wants? I just don't know. Or is this the one where we're using Marjorie's leverage? Let's use diplomacy, because hopefully what Mira's doing with Marjorie can help.
My new sentinel favors a certain approach, and I agree. I shall use diplomacy with Lord Snow. I would be foolish to pick a fight without negotiating first. I'll offer our allegiance and try to reach a reasonable agreement.
If you aren't ready for a fight, you're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Ethan has made his opinion known, and you will respect his decision.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Aye.
Well then, Let's decide how we shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival. Invite him into this hall and meet him face to face, lord to lord.
Ramsay Snow is no lord. That's absurd. You meet him at the gate with as much force as we can muster. Make him wait. Let him gaze upon Ironwrath. And when he enters, he'll know it's only because you allowed it.
Lord Ethan?
Invite him into the Great Hall. Alright, let's just go down this horrible path.
I will meet him in the Great Hall.
A wise move, my lord.
It's careless. Can't you see Tuttle is steering you wrong?
That's enough, Roiland. Lord Ethan has given his command.
How many years have I served this house? I cannot listen to that bloody idiot anymore. Forgive me, my lord, but you are not ready to be lord of this house. You're likely to get us all killed.
Get out.
You'll regret that, my lord.
Probably. I regret everything I'm doing.
Apologies, my son. I had expected better of him. But now that it is settled, we know what we must do.
We're going to get betrayed by him.
We will meet Ramsay Snow in the Great Hall, and we will not offer our ironwood.
And don't worry, Lord Ethan. I will stand beside you, where your sentinel belongs.
Then perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house. There will always be those who question your leadership, which is why you need allies you can rely on. Family.
I question myself.
Mira has done everything she can in King's Landing, but there are others who can help us. What about your brother, Asher?
Yeah, you went
Malcolm
behind
told
my
me.
Back.
You want to bring him back?
He's a skilled fighter. But what's more, he has the will to fight. A hunger for it. He always protected you and your sister. And we need all the help we can get.
Why would you bring him back after you exiled him?
He exiled himself. He has no desire to rule. Asher is volatile, but that is his strength too.
Volatile?
Do you remember the Miller's boy? How he tormented you? I wanted to intervene, but your father said Ethan must fight his own battles. But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the Miller's boy by the neck. That was his first instinct. Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth. Of course, your father was furious.
They called him Gummy from then on.
You were in danger, and there was nothing else Asher needed to know. Asher does not hesitate. He acts, and we need that. You have many fine qualities. But you do not have that anger inside you. It's something we could use.
I'm not like that. But I don't need to be, do I?
No. But you need someone who is standing beside you.
I don't know how to think about this.
I'm trying to do what's best for this family. What this family needs. Ethan, let me send Malcolm to Essos.
Ugh, another hard decision. Do we want this erratic brother here? Or do we want to keep Uncle? I don't know. You know what? Do we want it's basically choosing between one character. We're going to either have Malcolm around that we get to interact with, or this brother that we have never seen. Wow. I don't think I want the erratic brother. Because he would... I think if you chose the other guy as your sentinel, like the militant war guy, it'd probably be good to go get the chaotic fighting brother. But let's keep Malcolm here.
Sorry, Mother, but I can't have Malcolm bring Asher back. He will not go to Essos. That is the final word. Do you hear me?
All right, there we go.
I hear you, but this is a mistake. I wish you trusted me with this. Know that you never stand alone. You are a forester. Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help us yet.
Okay. But I like the uncle seemed to be more level-headed than this brother that chokes and knocks people's teeth out. You didn't really sell me on him.